Okay, so welcome to the third lecture of the series on Religion 5 for archviz, and today we're going to talk about face orientation. Face orientation is one of the most important topics if you're modeling something for Unreal. In fact, what I would suggest you to do is to make a checklist which contains all the important points you need to know when you're modeling something for Unreal, which I will tell you as we go along this series. So far, we have covered one point, which was to divide your mesh as much as possible into different slots or different objects. And the second point is the face orientation, which we will cover in today's lecture. So let's begin. Okay, so to understand the concept of face orientation, let's select any mesh. Let's select this one. And I will go into the edit mode. And let me display the normals. Okay, yes, let me increase the size 0.2. Okay, so you need to focus on this line. Now this line indicates that this side of this particular face is the external side. Okay, and this side, the one with no line at all, is the internal side. So the face with the line is the external side, and the face with no line at all is the internal side. So same is the case for this particular face as well. So this side is the external side, the one with the line. And this side is the internal side of the same face, the one with no line at all. So this is case number one. Okay, so let me discuss another case. Let's select another mesh like this one. I will go into edit mode. Let me decrease the size of the normal 0.1. Okay, yes. Okay, so now as you can see that if we select this face, now according to Blender, as indicated by this line, this side is the external side of this face. And this side, the one with no line, is the internal side of this face, which basically does not make any sense, because how can this side be the internal side? Okay, this one should be the external side. So same is the case for this face. As we can see that the line indicates that this side is the external side and this one is the internal side. So this one cannot be the internal side. This should be the external side. And same is the case for this face as well. Okay. So what I will do is I will recalculate the normals. And how will I recalculate the normals? I will select this face and I will press Shift N on my keyboard. And now Blender has recalculated the normals for this face. You can see that as indicated by this line, this is now the external side of this particular face. So now this one is the internal side and this one is the external side. Okay, I will do the same thing for this face as well. I will select this face and I will press Shift N on my keyboard. Now as indicated by this line, this one is the internal side and this one is the external side. I will do the same thing for this face as well. There is the line. Let me press Shift N on my keyboard. And now this is the external side. Okay. So now you need to make sure that whatever software that you are using, whether it's 3ds Max, whatever software you're using, you need to make sure that your normals are recalculated. Okay. Now this is very important, because if you do not recalculate your normals and you import this mesh as it is into Unreal Engine, Unreal Engine will simply ignore that particular face of that mesh. Okay. It will not be visible in Unreal Engine. So it is very important that you need to recalculate the normals of all the meshes that you have modeled so far and that you will model afterwards. So in Blender, there is actually a much better way to visualize the normals. Let me go into edit mode and I will disable the display of the normals. And now what I will do is I will enable the face orientation. Okay, so blue color here indicates that this is the external side of the wall. The red color in here indicates that this is the internal side of the wall. Okay, so we need to make sure that whatever the external side we have on our mesh, it should be color blue, and the whatever the internal side we have, it should be colored in red. So in other words, we need to recalculate the normals for this mesh, for this mesh, and for these windows as well, and for these windows as well. Okay, because they have bad normals. So what I will do is I will select this mesh and I will go into edit mode. I will select everything and I will press Shift N to recalculate the normals. Okay. So as stated earlier, I need this red color on the inside. because the internal sides are colored in red and the external sides are colored in blue. So any external side with red color should be converted into blue, and every internal side with a blue color should be converted into red color. Okay, so let's select this mesh as well, and I will go into edit mode. I will select everything and I will press shift and to recalculate the normals. Okay, so but as you can see that we are unable to recalculate the normals for this mesh. Even if I press shift N, it is not recalculating the normals. Okay, so we have a solution for this. What we need to do is select that particular mesh, and I will press shift N, and I will go into this option and I will check this box manually. And now as we can see that this red color lies on the inside and the blue color lies on the outside. Okay, same is the case for this face as well. So I will select this face, I will press shift N, and I will check this box, and now our normals are recalculated. Okay, yes. Okay, so we also need to recalculate the normals for these windows. So first I will select the frames, and then we will deal with the glass later. I will select everything and I will press shift N to recalculate the normals. Now the blue color lies on the outside and the red color lies on the inside. Okay, so yes. Okay, so now we need to recalculate the normals for this particular glass. But actually first what we need to do is we need to add some thickness, because this is just a single plane with four vertices. It does not have any sort of depth. It is just a single plane. So first we need to add some thickness to it. Okay, so I will use my solidify modifier and I will type in 0.001. Okay, so now as you can see that we do not have any feared shading. We do not have red color on the outside, but actually the red color will be on the inside. So I will do the same thing for this mesh as well. I will select this one and I will select this one. I will press Ctrl L and I will copy the modifiers. Okay. And I will do the same thing for these glass panels as well. 4, 5, 6. And I will select this one. I will press Ctrl L and I will copy all the modifiers. I will copy modifiers. Yes, now it's ready. Okay, so as you can see that the red color now lies on the inside, indicating that this is the internal side of the mesh. Okay, which makes total sense, because this should be internal side. The one with the blue color should be the external side. Okay, so now if we look at the mesh from the outside, everything is colored in blue. Don't worry about this weird shading. This is because the thickness of the glass is just too low. It won't bother us inside Unreal Engine. Okay. Okay, so this was a very important topic. That's it for this lecture, and I will see you guys in the next one.